The second game of the match then between Honor Players and Last Minute Arrivals is going to be played on home map of Last Minute Arrivals, and as you can see that's going to be an unusual one, and that is Vinland Saga. I definitely like this map in RTSD whenever it's played because it's so different gameplay than the normal maps, like for example the last Tundra and literally anything. The Marsh is played often, Mediterranean is played often. This is so different that it's always refreshing to see how players deal with the problems at hand. For the teams, we are seeing a bit of a switch for Last Minute Arrivals and actually also for the opponents, for Honor Players, as Last Minute Arrivals are switching in Chrono JJ instead of Matreus. And he's going to be playing Set, whereas Tom Picks is switching into Gaia from Oranos, and Heimdall is switching into Oranos also from Loki, so they definitely do have some special plan, as Set can be making some nice shenanigans with the Shifting Sands on this map. Otherwise, for the opponents, Metallo is switching into Oranos from Zeus, Illudai is switching into Set, he was Loki, I think, in the first game, and Goldlion is going to be replacing Sensu in this game, and, well, it's not going to be a replacement of the Civilization, as he's also sticking with Oranos. So basically double Atlantean plus Greek, or plus Greek plus Eggy on both sides. Well, we are then starting with looking at Tom Picks. As you can see, if you don't really know this map, you are starting on basically a small island. Let's just turn off the Fog of War for a moment. There you are having very limited resources, the base gold mine, a few berries, a few trees literally, not any kind of big wood, and a transport ship. So you are basically forced to land onto the mainland that is quite bountiful and rich on all the resources that you can actually need. Food, gold, town centers of course, and wood. And we are also seeing that there are a lot of fishies around the map. So water economy is also something that is quite viable. Let's turn on the Fog of War so that we see when players are actually moving forward, as you are right now looking at Tom Picks building an interesting dock, pretty decent, so not really any kind of problem, as he's of course seeing exactly enough fishies for making the dock in there, and Chrono JJ is already transporting the priest on the mainland so that he can convert some of the animals and scout with the hyena as well. It's looking like that Killua is gonna do the same exactly. I'll be looking where to find some of the guys that will help him from the Animal Kingdom. So far not really having any kind of luck at all. So that's slightly unfortunate for him, because of course this will mean that the red player, or the teal player, as I'm looking at the red of course, why I said red, he's going to be converting a few of the bees to help him in the early fights. And right now with Heimdall also being landed, he is going to be scouting as much as he can. Metallo though is also on the mainland already. Unfortunately, he has encountered the Ulsarks, the Skraelings, are going to be fighting against this Oracle, so he should be pretty much toast. As in this version, they are not really giving up on pursuing this guy, so he just basically can, well, all he can do is maybe lead them to his opponent. That would be a pretty good idea. Or he can just as well scout as much as he can. But yeah, leading it towards his opponent, like for example to the bottom next to the priest, that would be pretty strong for him. Because he would be basically a counterplaying what Chrono is doing. But unfortunately, if you are not used to playing this map, yeah, the thinking like that isn't exactly there. So it's seeming like, oh, there's going to be a bit more problem for him. Oh man, Metallo. You're actually going to be sacrificing both of them, because right now these dudes are going to be continuing against this guy, and with Chrono JJ's hyena also being in pursuit, it's basically right now sure that those two oracles are dead. One of them is already dead. You can see that Tom Picks is not going to be much better off, also losing one of the oracles. But still, Metallo is going to be left with just one, and that definitely sucks big time, because he's not going to be having all that much of a line of sight on the island, so it's going to be up to Goldlion and potentially some animals from Killudai to help with the scouting. But so far he hasn't scouted really all that much, as he doesn't have really any animals to convert for himself, kind of interestingly enough. Yeah, literally none. That's very curious, he's having no piggies to be converting. Only some wolves at the very top, but he probably hasn't found them yet. And we are right now looking at the temples being built by Heimdall and Chrono JJ, as they have both transported citizens and villagers on the mainland, and they will be hoping that they can somehow capture this TC, and potentially they would be interested in going in here, because of course this triple TC in the right side, that is basically on the half of the map that should be kind of belonging to Honor Players, They are close to each other, so if you are controlling one of those, especially the middle one, you are going to be having a pretty good chance of controlling the double as well, and since the other TCs are just thrown across the back of the map, this will be pretty important. Who controls this part of the map will be having a pretty good outlook on controlling the game overall. You should be seeing advances into Prometheus, of course, to Dark as you would be expecting, and that's actually a pretty nice play. Right now into Chrona's base, as you can see from the Gaia. Those trees are also going to be faster gathered from Chrona JJ, and he doesn't need to transport all that many villages all that fast onto the mainland. So basically he can keep them safe. Fortunately, a bit of idle time, actually a lot of idle time, with this one villager waiting for the houses on the mainland, or rather main island, not really mainland. And really, this is a nice idea, and it will help in the early economy and make it a bit safer for him, as we are also seeing Oceanus being researched right about now. So Gaia's forest right now going to be granted to Heimdall so that he can gather on his little island, whereas the opponents of course are doing nothing like that. They're just now advancing into the next ages because of course they don't have Gaia in their midst. Oh, that's unfortunate. You can see that is housed. Gotland is actually housed, and he is just now finishing with the manor. So that's quite unlucky because he's going to be one village down as opposed to what he could have been. And well, here we see finally some piggies that could have been converted by his lucky Ludai, but unfortunately for him was burned. I'm already coming in together with Chrona to have a bit of fun with the Prometheans and the priests. Of course, a bit more efficiency right about now by Chrona JJ because he was fighting against the Promethean as opposed to Kiludai, who wasn't. And with all the right now early army coming in from Chrona JJ, oh well, this is looking quite well for them, and they should be controlling the situation very nicely. But we are also seeing shifting sands right on top of the TC. Of course, all the extra passengers like the animals and the budget and the pharaoh and the TC should be coming up for them. Compix right now trying to get rid of the house basically with the carnivora, even though looking at the priest and the pharaoh, gonna be really standing for much longer, and we are right now definitely looking at the situation that you were talking about a bit earlier, and that means that Kiludai and his team should be kind of controlling this part of the map. But so far on the military department, it doesn't really look like that at all, because the animals are gonna die, all of them, like pretty much all of them, as Red is having such a big army right now in here. And not even the TC could be enough to actually stop this, even though animals are of course gonna die. You can see that he was actually trying to counter convert them. Oh, and he dies. Yeah, didn't run away fast enough. It means that there's going to be a bit more extra time for Metal to set up, as those dudes should be easily killed by the Pharaoh, so I don't really expect that much. Many problems should be really had here for Honor players. Looking otherwise on the water, we are so far seeing a bit of engagement mainly from Latlompex. You can see that he's already having the extra boats in the forefront, and it doesn't seem like that actually the opponents are fighting for the water all that much. Here you can see just Chrona JJ and Tompex trying to kill the economy of their opponents, which is of course going to be quite useful. Yeah, we literally there's the first cabinet being made, so at least now they are switching into it. But at the same time on the land, the army from last minute arrivals is really getting bigger by the time, and really the same cannot be said about the opponents, even though they seem to be quite nicely set up, and Gold Lion is finally going to be making his presence count. TC so far not really being captured by last minute arrivals, so they are having a bit different strategy than what usually is being played from Vinland Saga, like trying to somehow steal TC from their opponents through the shifting sands and such. So Red right now forced into a bit of a defensive, but with Chrona JJ supplying the slingers in here, and with the Carnivora still being very much alive with all the hit points, they are in a pretty good spot. And with the Galadria healing a bit, yeah, well, that's also nice help, so that the armies of last minute arrivals are not dying at all. You can see very nice setup all across the shore. So we are looking for armory, so potentially heroic age from Chrona JJ coming in, as we are seeing a bit of engagement by yellow, but unfortunately right at the moment, exactly the moment when he should be retreating, he was shockwave, so that was very nicely played by Heimdall in here, and he definitely got some extra damage into his opponent that is going to help him in the battles to come. Now JJ having pretty decent army already, with medium slingers also. Who in the Bubbly Balance Patch 2.0 get with medium slinger actually one extra range. They are going to be a whole lot better in that department. But looking at the army right now, it's kinda not bad. Not bad from other players, but they should be really careful about this extra damage that they are basically giving to their opponents, and that's something that might really come back to bite them quite a lot. So far though, this is a lot of slingers and turmas, so not really anything all that substantial that could be taken out buildings. You can see just this pure dude, pure dude trying to do something and make something happen. As yellow is having pretty nice reinforcements, just basically waiting in here. So I'm not exactly sure if he even knows about them. It's almost looking like that he doesn't. And that's really unfortunate, because that's a pretty decent army that could be helping with the engagement right next to the TC. On the water, there's a bit of more fighting right now happening, as Kiliudai is finally having some cabinets, a gold line is having helping with BRMS. But in the middle, it seems that last minute arrivals are still having situation in hand, and they are controlling what is going to happen on the water. Prusain already for Heimdall. With Chrono also having Prusain, if you have a look at those golden nets. And quite nicely developing across the shoreline, so that's a pretty great idea. And he's also moving with the boat of his own on the right, trying to see what's going to happen in there. If maybe his opponent is attending him, something like that. He has in the meantime shifted for a TC, of course, it's going to be very easily coming up, as he has transported like 27 villages. That's pretty decent, and since he's right now engaging with his allies, their opponents right next to the TC, he should be quite nicely covered. And since the TC is just now up, well, situation is getting kinda problematic, because with the extra fire from the town center, there's not much of a chance that honor players could be getting some tactical advantage above their opponents. And it's really looking like that they will be quite well off last minute arrivals to go. Yep. I'm convincing quite pretty soon, but they really need some, literally anything to get rid of the buildings, because so far just Lingers and Turmas was definitely not going to cut it. Going for TC red player, it seems like. Or not. Oh, where is he actually going? Not exactly sure, but this is looking like that he should be interested in the TC, as there is also a TC being captured by Tompix at the very back. There is a bit of fighting still happening on the water, and getting rid of the transport boat with 6 citizens, oh my! Well, that was last minute. If Goldline lost 6 citizens from the transport ship, well, that would be absolutely horrible for him. But you can see that there are pretty big problems right now coming up, because if he cannot transport those citizens safely from the little island, he's going to be kind of gold-starved and literally resource-starved. And it's really looking like that it might be exactly happening, because the boats from the purple player are basically all over the place. Also some extras at the very top. And really, the water seems to be much more controlled by last-minute arrivals than by the other players, even though they are still putting up a fight in there. This fight seems to be not really moving anywhere, but Chrono JJ just making use of this gold as much as he can before he's potentially pushed back. Definitely a good idea. As next gold is not really in the shoreline, you can see the red player finally trying to capture the town center. Right now scouted by Gold Lion, of course, and Carnivora at pretty good spot. Just not eating up Turmas before it died itself. But to finish my thought, the gold is in the middle of the map, so this DC is much more important for the game overall than anything else, because of course this gold seems to be like basically the only one in the reach of honor players, whereas all the rest is going to be pretty tough for them to control somehow. This is basically going to be the last gold that they will be having available at this position. Well, quite decent raiding. That's unfortunately for Kiliudai. He wasn't really getting gold at a good placement. And be gold starved quite strongly. Basically all of the gold released, 22 of them, not doing anything. But in the meantime, Goldline has captured the TC at the very back, which is of course good idea, something that will help him somehow keep the situation in check. And those dudes, yeah, they will have to deal with the scalings, as they are having a look at the TC and potentially at something else as well. So pretty big battle as Goldline is trying to stop EZ from coming up. But I'm not exactly sure that he will succeed. But looking at the armies, he definitely could. But with Chrono JJ right now jumping into Neftis, and Ancestors of course coming up at this very crucial spot in the game. Let's see if Goldline manages somehow micro this properly. But he's basically left with literally one heal to my armor. That's even a normal one. That's just shine from the priest. So there's just one piece against the Ancestors, and that's most definitely not enough. So they are single-handedly turning the battle around, and that means that the TC should be right now coming under Ivo Heimdall's power. And of course, with the Ancestors still alive, they're going to be attempting a bit of a push on the TC, and the Heroic Age should be resulting into Migdol, and of course, Siege Towers pretty soon. So nicely played so far from last minute arrivals, as they are of course. There were some extra villages. Other citizens from the blue player arriving on the mainland. And well, with the sounds of Ancestors dying, we are looking at actually exactly those guys who are all that was needed to turn this game around. And looking at Kiryudai, is he advancing somewhere sometime soon? Well, he definitely isn't. You can see that he's in a pretty tough situation. He doesn't have any kind of gold. You can see he's just moving all around, not finding anything that he could be gathering. And not even the blue player is seem to be allowing him to get from it, as he has basically not really cleverly built the houses right next to the gold, because he expected that the green player would be having some extra gold mine somewhere. And yeah, here we see this, the resign, as he is out of gold, not really any kind of chance of anything. And with each works coming up, that was definitely going to come down, even without the resign. So yeah, just to finish my thought in here, the metal basically is blocking the gold altogether, because he made those manors so that he could protect his citizens and basically made it harder for the opponents to raid him, but it has unfortunate effect that of course Kiryudai cannot gather from it, and he had to move somewhere else, but yeah, he found a bit of opposition in there. And the gold was all the way back, which definitely could have been found. Could have been found by him, but yeah, in the end it wasn't. And gold starving basically worked for them, and better tactical play from last minute arrivals is meaning that they are tying the match at the 1-1. That was nicely played with Nant Saga, a bit differently than what you usually see, but definitely confirming that this map is not thought through, and it's definitely not Atlantean only map. You can make some things happen with Egyptians as well, and I wouldn't be surprised if with Norse as well, if you play them correctly. But players don't really experiment enough with maps like these. Chrono JJ win the most food and overall the best score. I kinda agree with that, because he was playing the best and basically was the most important part of the game. You can see he was already maxed at 80 villages. Whereas Kiryudai was just at 7. That's how far ahead he actually was in the game. And well, the advances for Metal of 507, Kiryudai 515, Goldline 533, as the opponents Heimdall 439, Chrono JJ 448, and Topex 502. So you can see that preparation for the home map definitely paid off for last minute arrivals, and they did surprise their opponents. Not gold total, but gold. You can see green player having pretty big problems. And gold total is actually pretty interesting as well, because you can see that he basically plateaued together with gold line. They weren't gathering any gold from like, I can see 10 minutes. From like 10 minutes, they weren't getting any gold. That's basically when they ran out of the gold on their main island, rather home island, and they couldn't get anything on the mainland in there. So, yep. Was nicely played from the opponents to actually keep them at such a stage. So, GG.